Hi everyone, I'm Jason Ballas for OutdoorProductReview.com. Today we're going to do a little bit of a different test for bows as far as this goes. We're actually doing a takedown recurve. It's the Hatfield for Martin. I'm pretty excited about this because I started shooting a recurve when I was just real young. 36 years ago or so, I grew up with an old little Fred Bear recurve that I had when I was a kid, and I still have that thing to date. And I love shooting it. I've had some great recurves in my bow hunting past, if you will. I've had the Fred Bear takedown. I've had a takedown that was the Ben Pearson takedown signature series. And, you know, if you start shooting a recurve and then move to compound, it's just an amazing deal. Because if you learn to shoot instinctively, when you go to shoot a regular bow, I mean, you can just make those shots count that you need to. But I want to cover some stuff. Martin has sent this. And I want to tell you folks, this is a beautiful, beautiful piece of workmanship that they have here. Martin has a full array of recurve bows along with compound bows. And I've not been disappointed by anything that Martin's put out. So let's take a look here. And I want to show you some of this. All right, I'm going to start out with opening the package. We'll go through the whole process of putting it together and covering the bow in the review. All right, first off, you're going to have your main part of your riser. Now, the video probably won't do this any justice, but the workmanship and the quality of this wood is just gorgeous. I mean, it's got such a pretty wood like grain to it, the red, the purple, the orange. I mean, it is beautiful. It already has basically a cushion on the shelf. When I shoot a recurve, I like shooting off the shelf. And that's just, it's personal preference, but I really like shooting off the shelf. I like the way it feels. You have to shoot the feathers, of course. And for that, for testing today, I'm going to be shooting these Alaskan Bowhunting Grizzly Stick arrows. Now these things are just awesome. They're a tapered arrow, solid arrow. They're not even carbon. They're some kind of weave together something or other, but strong as nails, 600 and some grains per arrow, and just great. I'm going to be going on a bison hunt here in a couple of months, and this is what I'm going to be using. I'm not going to be using a recurve, however, I will be using this big old grizzly stick, so you could shoot it out of a recurve and or a compound bow. And 600 some grain arrow, it's a little slower out of that compound, but I'm telling you what, the kinetic energy is just amazing downrange. They're cut at 28 inches. Of course, they sent it to me with feathers and stuff. I have a few that I'll be shooting with fobs for the buffalo, so that's going to be something really cool. All right, so let's go ahead and go through this bow. First off, you got both limbs. Each limb is ready to go there. It comes all wrapped and stuff and all this. You got another limb. And you have basically, you know, the way you put it all together here. So let me unscrew this. Now you got to be careful too, because you want to look and see which one's your top limb and which one's your bottom limb on this. So I love shooting a recurve, folks, and this is something that just gets me back to the basics, and I really like that. So you take your bow, you have the top here, okay. And this is your bottom limb. The one that has the sticker on it is your bottom limb. So that's going to go down here. And they got two slots. They got two male ends here sticking out of the main riser. Then you have two female ends here, and when your bolt goes through. So, put it together. Simple as pie. It's got a spacer inside there to make sure that it's set in there perfect. You just sort of finger screw these in. That way, you know, you don't worry about cross-threading or ruining the threads or anything. Because I'm telling you something, this is such a beautiful bow. I'd hate to see it get messed up. Got my handy Allen wrenches here, just make sure I got the right size. Okay, and we're going to use a 3/16 inch, normal one you usually use on bows. Take, and like everything else, you don't want to over tighten, folks. You remember that. I always say that. Just tighten it snug. Okay, and then of course, after a first couple shots, you want to make sure that you didn't over tighten it. Take your top limb, put it on the two male ends. It fits right into place. There's no way you could possibly screw this up and torque your limb or anything. So, I always like to, when I put the bolt in first, I turn it to the left till it clicks in, and then that way you're perfectly straight. So, this is nice, because you know, if you like recurve shooting, and you're out there hunting, say you go to Africa or some other place, and you don't want your bow damaged, break down your recurve bow, put it in, you know, carry it on with you on the plane, or whatever the case is, wherever you're going. As long as you don't have your arrows or anything, I don't know what they'd think about broadheads or something. However, just take them with you. And that way you don't worry about your bow getting damaged in shipment. So there are the bows all put together. That took about 20 seconds or so once you got the bolts in there. And then it comes with a string. Comes with the string. Knock point already put on there. I did that. And then you just string the bow like you would any other recurve. Right, and they have a string aid, if you will, helps you do that. So we'll go ahead and put that up all together. Now, I'm not going to shoot this bow through the chronograph because it's not really going to give you any sense with the 600 grain arrow. You know, somebody had, on one of the videos that I did for the 08 bow review, had commented and said something about that I was shooting a recurve on one of the bows, and I says, well, you tell me a recurve that shoots 313 feet per second, and this was on YouTube, and you know, I'll buy that recurve if it shoots 313 feet per second, because I'll tell you what, that would be awesome. And like I said, I just love shooting a recurve bow. Now, pretty simple. Just put your this on this one. And then all you have to do is stand on a string to flex the limbs to be able to pull the string over the top. Okay. So you string it on. When you do string it, make sure, before you let down, that all the strings are on perfectly. And you saw what I did there. I just pulled it up. Okay, check, make sure your strings are centered. There's a groove that comes down from the tip of the limbs on both sides. And there you go. I mean, she's ready to go. You know, we're regular Robin Hoods out here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful looking bow. I can't say that enough. I mean, there's not a scratch or a blemish on it. The limbs are in awesome condition. I mean, I am just happy with it. Put your arrow on there. And she's set. Knocking point's perfect. We're ready to fire. I don't have any finger tabs or nothing, so I'll probably just shoot a couple times, but I do love shooting this bow. And it's quiet. You don't even need string silencers on here. Just flies beautiful. Beautiful and quiet. Awesome. That is a great shooting bow. Well, as you saw, folks, I shot this bow. I put her all together, strung her up. It was easy as pie. The bow shoots just beautiful. I mean, it is just quiet. You don't even hear nothing. I mean, it's just great. It's a great pulling bow. It's 28 inches at 60 pounds, which is more than plenty for any kind of deer or elk or anything. And you know, following it up with a real heavy arrow with a good broadhead on it's going to put the most damage on anything that you can see out there. You know, the AMO on it is 62 inches. Fits beautiful in your hand. I just want to praise Martin for the color of wood and the quality that they've put into making this bow. Everything's perfectly aligned and matches perfect. It would make a trigonometry's professor just smile from ear to ear the way that they've done this whole thing and put it together. I really do appreciate Martin helping us out here and letting us review some of their equipment, because man, this is a great product right here. Like I said, this is the Hatfield Takedown from Martin. But I would have to give this a bow craftsmanship draw a 10 right across the board for recurves. I just love shooting a recurve bow. And I want you guys to check back. We're going to start having some drawings for some real cool gear here soon that we evaluate. And some of these sponsors will be able to help provide you with some of the equipment that you're seeing on here. So please shoot me an email with anything you want to see evaluated out there, and we'll try and get it on there. So for OutdoorProductReview.com, I'm Jason Ballas, and we're going to see you on the next review of whatever it is we're reviewing. Take care.